This video is to demonstrate the preparation and procedure to flush a vascular access device using a standard aseptic non-touch technique. A standard ANTT approach is commonly used for flushing vascular access devices. There is an ANTT guideline available on the NHS GGC clinical guideline platform. The guideline is useful as it contains advice surrounding the different situations or scenarios where you might use either a standard or a surgical ANTT approach. ANTT is also incorporated into each procedural template within the NHS GGC Vascular Access Devices Care and Maintenance Guideline. This guideline is also available on the clinical guideline platform. Throughout the procedure, you will be expected to follow appropriate infection control precautions with regards to performing essential hand hygiene and wearing necessary PPE. It is really important that we perform an effective flush of any vascular access device. This is to maintain patency of the device and to minimise the risk of any contamination that could cause a device-related bloodstream infection. I have performed hand hygiene and put on PPE. The first thing that I need to do is decontaminate the surface area that I will be using. I'm using a detergent wipe to do this. Any surface that can be decontaminated appropriately can be utilised. I'm now going to remove my PPE and perform hand hygiene. The next step is to get the equipment I need ready. I need to use a syringe that is at least 10 ml in size. Any syringe smaller than 10 ml will exert too high a pressure through the device and risk the device fracturing. This could put the patient at risk of infiltration or extravasation. I might need to use a syringe that is larger than 10 ml, depending on the volume of flush to be administered. But it is crucial that I do not use anything smaller than a 10 ml syringe when flushing any vascular access device. I also have a blue 23-gauge hypodermic safety needle. An alternative would be a blunt filter needle, such as this one. It can be recognised by the red plastic sheath and the pink needle hub. I have wipes containing 2% chlorhexidine and 70% isopropyl alcohol. It's fundamental that I use these as this is the most effective solution at getting rid of any extrinsic microorganisms that might lead to bloodstream infection. I'll need one to decontaminate the ampoule of 0.9% sodium chloride and one for decontaminating the needle-free access device later. If I am using more than one ampoule, or if the device I am flushing has more than one needle-free access device, then I would need to collect additional wipes as appropriate. Finally, I have an ampoule of sterile 0.9% sodium chloride. The solution and expiry date need to be checked. Current guidance for flushing vascular access devices is that we use at least double the capacity of the device lumen, so you might need to use a larger volume of flush solution depending on the device you're using. Paediatrics and neonatal services may need to consider a smaller flush volume. I have performed hand hygiene again and put on new PPE. The first thing I'm going to do now is decontaminate the neck of the flush ampoule using the wipe. I'm doing this for 30 seconds and then I need to allow the solution to dry naturally. This also takes about 30 seconds. While that is drying, I'm going to use an aseptic non-touch technique to peel open the hypodermic needle and syringe packets to reduce contaminating the key parts, which in this instance are the syringe tip and hub of the needle. I now need to connect the needle and syringe together without touching the key parts. I now need to open the ampoule and draw up the flush solution. I have drawn up the full 5 ml into the 10 ml syringe. The safety shield on the hypodermic needle should then be activated on a hard surface. The next step is to remove the needle from the syringe and discard it straight into the sharps bin, taking care not to touch any key part. I can now protect the tip of the syringe from contamination using the syringe packaging as a microcritical aseptic field. I'm now going to remove my PPE and perform hand hygiene again before taking my prepared equipment to the patient. I have performed hand hygiene again and put on new PPE. I am now ready to decontaminate the needle-free access device using a new 2% chlorhexidine and 70% isopropyl alcohol wipe. This is commonly referred to as scrubbing the hub. I'm holding the device securely and I'm going to clean the needle-free access device for a minimum of 30 seconds. As it is a lure lock connection on the device, there are small threads on it, so you really want to give these a thorough scrub to remove any extrinsic microorganisms present. I now need to let that solution dry for about 30 seconds. An effective scrub the hub technique is vitally important, as the needle-free access device is sitting on the patient's skin and can get contaminated easily. So we need to do everything we can to decontaminate it thoroughly in order to reduce the risk of bloodstream infection. Now the solution has dried, I can connect the syringe to the needle-free access device. I have already ensured there is no air in the syringe, but holding the syringe downwards stops any microbubbles present entering the patient. Hold the syringe plunger and undo the clamp. The clamp may be part of the vascular access device itself or on the needle-free extension. It's important to reposition the clamp every time you use it, as you don't want any kinks or indents in the line. Reposition the clamp slightly, and if there is any slight indentation present, roll it gently between your fingers and thumb to remove it. The next step is to administer the flush using a really good pulsatile push-pause technique to create a turbulent flow. The turbulent flow removes any debris from the lumen of the device. During administration of the final mill flush, the clamp is applied, while I continue to push down on the plunger at the same time. This creates positive pressure. This last part of the flush technique, clamping the device under positive pressure, is to prevent reflux of blood into the tip of the vascular access device that could then coagulate and block the device. Now that I have flushed the device, I can put my used equipment into the clinical waste, remove my PPE and perform hand hygiene. To summarise, this video has demonstrated a standard ANTT approach to the preparation and administration of a pulsatile, push-pause, positive pressure flush. The same technique should be used for all vascular access devices.